Electronic mail is a popular communication medium to send text, images, videos, and files to hundreds and thousands of people around the world. And as Pythoners ourselves, we may come across the question, can we send emails using Python? So in this video, I'm going to show exactly how you can programmatically send emails in Python. If you're into Python like me, you can join our community All About Python by subscribing on YouTube, following on Instagram, or joining our newsletter through our blog site allaboutpython.tech. So without any further ado, let's begin. The task of sending mails in Python can be achieved using a few libraries. If you want to send a simple text mail without any HTML content or image, you can just use the smtplib package. But if you want to send mails with HTML content or images, you can use the email package along with smtplib. For this demo, we will use both smtplib and email package to send mail. We will discuss two scripts, htmlmail.py and textmail.py, each having code using and without using email package respectively. For all the viewers following this tutorial for learning, I would recommend using an Outlook account to send mail rather than a Gmail account because of two reasons. Number one, unlike Gmail accounts, you don't need to specify a phone number to create the account. And number two, with the updated Gmail settings, it's much more difficult to send mail from a Gmail account compared to sending mail from an Outlook account. I have already created a sample Outlook account that will send message to All About Python channel's official mail ID using the Python script. With the setup instructions clear, let's start writing some code. I have my VS Code editor open here, and I will start by creating a file and naming it textmail.py. Within the file, I will first import all the required modules. We will import getPass to get the Outlook account password from the user using the console. We will also import smtplib to send email through the mail server. Next, we will create a few variables. Create a variable named host with value smtp-mail.outlook.com. This is the SMTP server domain name of Outlook. If you are using another provider like Gmail or Yahoo, then you would need to change this value. You can view the list of providers and their associated SMTP server domain names here. Create a variable named port with value 587. This is the port at which we will connect to the SMTP server. Most of the servers use port 587 for SMTP, but you can view in this list which providers use the alternative 465 port. Next, create a variable named from_email with value allaboutpython-test-account2@outlook.com. This is the test email account I am using to send the mail. You can change this value with the email ID of the account you are using. Create a variable named to_email with value allaboutpythoninfo@gmail.com. This is the All About Python channel's official email ID. We will send our test email onto this ID. You can change this email ID to send mail to another ID. Create a variable named password and get its value from getPass.getPass function. Within this function, we will pass a string value. The function will print the prompt message that we have passed here and will take password from user. The password will not be visible on console but will be entered and understood by the program and saved inside the password variable. Next, create a variable named message which will contain the message we need to send through the mail. Now there is a specific format you need to set to send the message. The first line of the message should start with subject, colon, followed by the subject of the mail you want to set. From the next line, you can write the body of the message in plain text. With all the variables created, let's start connection to the server. We will create a variable named smtp which will store an object of smtplib.smtp class. The class will take two required parameters, the host and the port, which we have already created above. Next, we will create the ehlo method, or we will call the ehlo method of smtp object. This function will ping the server and check if the server is up and running or not. This function will return a tuple containing the status code of the response and the response message received from server. We will also add a print statement just to view how the response looks. Next, we will call the smtp.startTLS function. This function will establish TLS connection between our system and the server. This is especially important to perform if you want to send your mails securely over the internet. This function will also return a tuple containing the status code and the response message. We will again add a print statement just to view the response. Next, we will log in to server using our account's email ID and password. We will call the smtp.login function and pass the email ID and password here. Just like the previous functions, this function will also return a tuple containing a status code and a response message. We will again add a print statement to view the response. After successful login, we can send our mail using smtp.sendMail function. The function will take in two parameters from email, to email and the message. Finally, to close the connection with the server, we will call the smtp.quit function. Now let's run the script and see how it looks. As you can see, the script first asked me for the password, which I entered here. Next, it echoed the server and displayed its information. Next, it displayed the information on starting TLS connection. And finally, it displayed the information on logging on the server. You can add more print statements to view more information if you like. Now, if I open the All About Python Gmail account, you can see that we have received a mail from our test account. On opening the mail, we can see the subject we wrote here and the message we wrote here. This is how you can send a simple text mail. For the next step, we will create a script capable of sending HTML content on mail using the email package. We will start by creating a new Python file and naming it htmlmail.py. We will also create a mail.html file which will store the HTML mail we want to send. For this, we will use a simple HTML file with all the necessary tags like HTML, head, body, etc. And we will add two paragraph tags and write a simple message here. If you want, you can add more content and CSS here to make it more attractive. Within the htmlmail.py file, we will start by importing the package. The getPass and smtplib package will remain the same, but we will also import two modules in email package, namely mimemultipart and mimetext. Mimemultipart is used to create the email message object, and mimetext is used to add HTML content onto the mail. Just like the previous script, we will create few variables like host, port, from email, to email, and password. You can change these values according to your needs. Next, we will create a variable by the name message which will contain the object of class mimultipart. We will pass in a string parameter with value alternative which refers to mime type mime slash alternative. Within the message object, we will set some data regarding the mail like subject, from, to, cc, bcc, etc. For this, we will treat this object like a dictionary and add key value pairs to it. Here, I've specified the subject of the mail, the from email address, the to email address, the email address to be added in cc, and finally the email address to be added in bcc. Next, we have written a block of code to just read the HTML content that we have saved inside mail.html file. We will save the content within HTML variable. Next, we will create a new variable HTML underscore part and store the object of class mimetext inside it. Mimetext class is used to convert plain text content onto the correct format based on the mime type passed onto it. In this case, we are passing the HTML content here and specifying the mime type as HTML. Once the HTML part is ready, we will simply attach the HTML content onto the message by writing message.attach_html_part. The rest of the code remains similar to the one we had written in the previous Python script. We create a SMTP class object, echo the server, start TLS connection, login using account details, send the mail, and then quit. The one thing that has changed is in the send mail code. In this line, we previously just parsed the message in plain text. But since we are using the myMultipart class object, we will call the as_string function to get a plain text string format of the mail, which we will pass to the sendMail function. Let's save and run this script to see how it works. As you can see, we got a console message similar to the previous one. But if we check the email content, we can see that the message now has the HTML content which we will write within the mail.html file. With this, we end today's tutorial. Hope you liked it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and check out some of the other videos of this channel on other useful topics. If you're more of a reader type, you can also check out our blog site where we have created a blog on the same topic along with blogs on other interesting topics. With this, it's time for me to go. This is Vishesh Dwivedi signing off.